Hi friends, so we are here in the backyard continuing our decluttering series. And if you are decluttering again, please know that we are in this together. I'm here to hopefully give you some motivation. Know that I'm right there with you, holding your hand. We're gonna get through this. It's a lot of decision making, but you can make those decisions. Do it in little chunks, do it in big chunks, do it in timed hours. Like, so for us, we found that 4 hours is pretty much our energy level, but maybe for you it's just an hour, or even it's just a half hour, so many times a week, or even just once a week. Whatever you can get through is one step closer to getting that space that you need. So for us, it's downsizing my mom. She's already moved into her new place, so we've got to get this on the market. And now we are going to continue with the back patio and the backyard. So let me just give you an overview of what it looks like. Okay, so this is the back patio of the house, and my dad was wonderful. He just knew how to build things. He was an engineer by career and a civil engineer, but he was also very handy. So he built that sink that attaches to the garden hose this sink. And then I think that was a grill. So we got the furniture out because my brother from out of state had already been here. So he went through what he wanted to bring. So luckily he took that furniture, the patio furniture. And you know, my dad built that too. That's a deep freezer. And that is a hutch that they've had since I was a kid. And when I was a kid, that was a long time ago. And over here he had some grills. I think my brother took the grill, I can't remember. And then we have this trailer. So my brother wants the trailer, but he just doesn't have the time right now to come and pick it up. So he's trying to figure out a way to bring it. And I've asked the realtor, I have to take a picture of this, if this would be okay to stay here, to kind of stage that size trailer can fit back here and go through the gate, go through the side gate. Oh gosh, maybe I should show you the side gate. So I don't know if you can see that. That's all the trash. And luckily our neighbor, I mean, there's, oh my gosh. I was looking through the camera and I thought that was a bobcat. I almost screamed and ran into the house. That must be the neighbor's cat. Sorry, kitty. I don't know whose cat that is. I'm not from here. But anyway, this right here, that's a whole pile of garbage. I already filled up the two garbage cans. Usually you only get two, one. But anyway, the next door neighbor is taking care of bringing it out for garbage day. And then that's gonna be all junk removal, including the mattresses. I have the landscaper coming out today. Yeah, I think it's supposed to, he said in the morning, so I don't know now. I mean, he hasn't been here. And then the handyman's also coming. And my dad made this roaster. It's actually for a whole pig. We're Filipino, so we do roasted pig, which is lechon. We do that for special occasions. Okay, there's the cat. Yeah, my dad made a bunch of stuff. He had a green thumb, so you couldn't tell by the plants right now, because I certainly don't have a green thumb. I have a decent thumb. And then we do have a pool service coming every week. And I don't know what it is, but it's just never been the blue that my dad was able to get this to. So I'm a little disappointed. If you're watching this, just know I'm a little disappointed, but we just keep paying. It's not worth my time to find a new person because we just need it clean enough to sell, and then the people can deal with that later. Yeah, so you can see like the whole the landscaper really needs to come. So our plan for today, so when you have a big huge thing like this and you have a bad back like me and it's just me and my daughter, lots of stuff, we're just gonna leave things where they are and then have the junk removal people take care of it. Like, why move it into a pile when they can just come and get it themselves? Okay, and my parents used to have a chicken coop back there which laid nice eggs, but someone reported them. they're not allowed to have chickens here because of the HOA, but anyway, I tell you, this shopping cart had that since I was a kid. My dad took it from a supermarket. It was so funny. I remember I was so embarrassed that he did that, but hey, it hauled a lot of stuff in our day. And you know, they didn't have those like portable wagons, right, for like soccer that they sell now everywhere in Costco and Amazon. And I don't know if you guys know this, but yeah, see, there's no houses here behind them. It's enough space. So when you're inside, you're not going to hear that traffic. And it used to be a lot quieter on this road. You know, they were here for, I think, 15 years, barely any cars going by. But now, you know, the whole city's been, the whole, all of Phoenix is developing. And so there's a lot of houses now, apartments, strip malls. And so this road has gotten busier. But when you're out here, it's fine, because when the water's on, because those are waterfalls, it's just a nice sound. You just hear the water. Okay, it's 10:40 a.m. So what I think what I'm going to do for this video is just walk around and show you. We're just going to go through stuff and see if it's anything that is worth keeping for ourselves, worth donating, even for like the like cleaning supplies and hazardous stuff. We have a pile in the garage, and I think what we're gonna do, instead of moving it ourselves, we'll just tell the junk removal people that that's what we're gonna do. Okay, so something like this, you know, I already have two of these, so I think this will be Goodwill. And our process is, my daughter's here, and I just tell her which pile to put it in. Okay, so mainly, so like this. I mean, it looks like my dad welded that together. So it looks like a lot of chemical or cleaning stuff. And we already have a bunch from the other, like the laundry room and the garage. So I don't think I'm gonna take any more, because honestly, I don't have space in my garage anymore. Okay, we're gonna go here. So even this, oh, I mean, we don't need that. We found an older one. We already are gonna bring that to listen to the cassette tapes, if there's any recordings I've done on there. All right, so yeah, we're good here. This is all gonna be junk. Okay, yeah. Oh, you know, the crazy thing happened too. Like, I almost fired this pool person, and you're probably gonna tell me, why didn't you? He drained the pool, you know, charged me to drain the pool and fill it up, because he was like, the only way for it to get blue is to shock treat it or whatever it is. I don't own a pool, so I know nothing. Well, I came in here. Oh no, my neighbor sent me pictures that there is a little river flowing in the front yard. Well, he left the water on to fill the pool. He said it takes 2 days. He was surprised this has never happened to him in 15 years. And this whole place got a little bit flooded, probably 2-3 inches of water. Anyway, you know, it eventually drained, but it's kind of, listen, I'm a nice person. It takes a lot for me to fire you. So I was willing to oversee that, because it was just a lot of work to find any pool person. And actually, our pool person is that neighbor's pool person, the other neighbor. You know, when you're taking care of something like this, I'm sharing that because you're gonna go through, you know, nothing, it's not gonna be perfect. It's not gonna be a straight line to what you want to achieve. Okay, isn't that just like, that's just like life. Oh my gosh, look at this. See, this is sentimental. Okay, look at this, 1973, Sicily. Oh, I'm sorry, forgot. Okay, can I keep this? I'm gonna find something for that. You know, I love kits, so we're gonna do something with that. I don't need this for the fireplace. So this is Goodwill. All chemicals. That's gonna either be, I think that should just be trash. I don't know if I should do that, Goodwill, okay. All right. Oh, maybe we want this little gas can. Unless my husband has one already. Okay, yeah. So I don't know if this is something he made, but junk removal. Not that it's junk, okay? You know, there's memories tied, and you have to make choices of, because you can't keep everything. I mean, look at that. The landscaper is coming here. The guy who's gonna clean the yard. Oh my goodness, this is all their pool stuff. Okay, so we don't need this. It's gonna be thrown. Oh, okay, my nieces are now middle school and upper grade school, so they don't need those floaties. But of course, my parents kept it, kept them. I'm gonna see if my neighbor wants those. So my dad's next door neighbor, they fix cars together. I mean, they're both very handy. So we gave him, we were basically like, take whatever you want. And he is. So it's great, because if not, we'd have to either try to sell it or find someone to buy this stuff. And I don't have time to sell things, no matter how easy you think it is. Probably easy for you, it's very hard for me. So those are the choices you have to make too, is am I gonna sell and take the time and meet people on Facebook Marketplace and have them negotiate with you? And you know, is it worth your time and cash? Okay, so these things like the bird feeder, we're gonna let go of those. This was a gift. It's a reminder of when my husband first opened his business. So we'll probably take these. We'll take the two wind chimes, because those are actually good wind chimes. I texted the guy who does a business of the roasted pig if he wants this. He didn't reply. So that's eventually going to be junk if he doesn't want it. Okay. And you can see my dad built that pool thing. Okay. And look. Oh, even has there. My dad loved to label and put dates on things. Bet you that's where I got it from. I love to label with a label maker, but I don't put dates. Okay, and then this is obviously all junk. All right, honestly, we're done with the backyard. Okay, guys, we are done with the backyard, and I know I look crazy. Listen, it's Saturday morning, and I seriously just wanted to stay in bed. And you're gonna go through those challenges of, you know what, you don't feel like it, but we're kind of, I feel pressed for time. Like, I've got to get this house done, because it's just one big thing off of my plate, you know? And that's what's motivating me, is to just get this done. Okay, so anyway, what you can see with the backyard, as I walked you through, a lot of it is just gonna be for the junk removal people. So we're not even going to touch it, because I've hired junk removal people before. This is probably gonna cost a pretty penny, because I had like a mattress and a couple pieces of furniture, and they charge by like space. So if it takes this amount of space, honestly, it was like $300. So I don't know what this is going to cost. I'll let you know. But I looked when I was doing it for myself, and they were all about the same price. So I don't know if this is like, you know, a scam or that's the business. So anyway, it is what it is. And we're going to spend that money, because it's worth our headache. Okay. But yeah, so something like this, you could see, we just basically, a lot of it is junk removal, no need to move stuff. We've got a few items that we wanted to keep or put to Goodwill. Did I want to keep it? I don't know. Oh yeah, just the tackle box. And I'm totally going to make use of that. I could, you know, I love tackle boxes and organizing things in those. So anyway, hope you, this was helpful. Click the playlist, to watch my whole series of downsizing a home after loss, and click the next one for the garage.
If you need help decluttering, I've created a free PDF checklist, 24 things to declutter. They're quick and easy, and probably things you've been thinking about letting go of. Well, here's your sign to do so. Click the link in the show notes below, put in your email, and you'll receive the download immediately. You've got this.